Hey guys, what's going on? My hair's up. Anyway, I was at work today and Katrina asked me a question. Mystic Brady, she asked me a question about Jalissa Fuentes. So I have the Necrophonics on my phone, which I'm recording on right now, but I went ahead and turned it on and wrote down like the question that I was asking and asked it in my head, and then I heard the response and wrote down the responses. So I really wasn't planning on doing another case right now because I'm just busy with life, unfortunately. So I'm gonna go over here to my car and I'm gonna get the notebook that I wrote everything down with. Hot. Texas heat, guys. I don't know why, but it's September and it's hot as heck. Look at my roses. Ah, roses. Yep. I have a huge rose bush. So my location hasn't changed. I'm still seeing the bridge. I even heard the bridge today in the EVP. So I'm still gonna say that that bridge. The only thing that has changed is the action has changed, or maybe I'm just now getting the actions that took place. Not real sure. So, whew, that was a walk, and I'm hot. Yeah, I was trying to do housework, and nothing ever works like me. It's like I want it to. I worked all day, and I had very little sleep. Coral had a friend over last night, and that girl and her were happy. Holy moly. Come on. I know I wrote it in this notebook. That's what I'm looking. I'm like, oh, what did it do with it? I heard it's in the back. You sure? I went through the back. There's the map I did for Dylan's case. Okay. So you don't think I'm cheating you guys. There's my handwriting. Okay. All right. Okay. Let me turn the light on so I can read it. Yeah, I'm sorry I haven't been on, guys. I apologize. I've just been so busy. Like, I don't know what's going on. If work is crazy, it's really not, and then I don't know, life is just taking control. I'm gonna lower y'all for a second. Okay, so this is from today. I wrote down Jalissa's name, and then I said, "Are you near a graveyard?" Because I did hear graveyard on a EVP before, and I was just like, maybe that was just random. And then what I heard was, no, my dad knows. Never heard about her dad until today. Of course, entertainment purposes only, and for my own, what's the word? Intuitive take of it, okay? Just what spirit told me. I'm not saying it's 100% true. I'm saying that this is just what the spirit told me. Come at me. I'm not accusing anyone. I'm not putting fingers on anything. I'm just trying to make sense of what's going on. Okay? And I cannot get a good spot for you guys. I will have to work. Okay. So basically, I asked Jalissa, "Are you near Avocado Lake?" And I heard, "I don't know what to do." I see, Jalissa, are you far? Are you far? Are you from? Wait, how far? Yeah, how far are you from Avocado Lake? I heard 7.1, and it sounded like they said feet, but then I went, "There's no way they've searched that whole area." So I'm gonna say probably miles, within 7 miles of the lake. Maybe a radius like of 7 miles around the lake. Start searching.
What happened, Delissa, to your car? I heard, shove me in, ow. I said, okay, that's kind of scared me. I said, who shoved you in your car? I heard, David. He knows. I was like, okay. I said, did David have anything to do with you going missing? I heard, David did it. Don't tell anyone. I don't know why. Maybe there was a secret between her and David. And that's the don't tell anyone. So where are you, Jalissa? And you said, you can, I said, you can tell me, can you tell me the town landmark or anything like what you're by? I heard north of river Kings. So I put Kings River question mark and said, crossing didn't make it, sorry. Okay. I'm going to keep going because I have wrote down more. I said, Jalissa, where is your car at? I said, when you were shoved into it, where was your car at? Like, I literally wrote down the words. So, like, every word is written. Okay? I said, when you were shoved into it, where was it at? And I heard, down the street. And then I heard, I'm sorry. So I said, Jalissa, did you meet up with someone that night? And then it said, a boy, he didn't show. I said, where is your car? It said, down a cliff. I said, by avocado? I said, is your car in? Oh, in Kings River. I couldn't tell what that was. I was scribbling. Because when I'm trancing, I'm just writing and I'm not thinking, and sometimes it comes off weird. So I said, is your car in Kings River? And they said, where are the big bridges? That's what I said. Where are the bridges? I said, and then I heard, couldn't cross. Bridge gave away. So take that as you will. Did they push you into the cliff? And then it heard, yes. Yes, twice. And it said, he did help. So I don't know if somebody kidnapped her, put her in her car, drove her car out there, and then pushed it off into a cliff. But I'm starting to see a picture build here, and it's really starting to freak me out a little bit. I was thinking that it was an accident, that she might have accidentally drove over this bridge, and that's how she got there. But now I see this, I'm thinking, did somebody do this? Is this foul play? Like, what's going on? Okay. And I said, why would David, that's the name I got. I said, why would David do this? And then I heard, I was moving out. I don't know. I thought she lived with her grandmother. So that's confusing. And then I said, was David the one who pushed you into the car? And I heard yes three times by different spirits. And then I said, okay. Okay. There's some questions on here that I'm not comfortable putting out there just yet. So I might put them up later. I'll mark them. Okay, who put you in the car? And I heard, David, really? Like, David, really? Really, it was him. So, I also heard something else there. So, that goes with that whole, I'm not comfortable saying it yet. Why would he do that? That's what I asked. Why would he do that? Put you in your car and put your car in a cliff. And somebody came out real loud and said, go ask him now. I don't know who David is. So if you know the David in this case that she might be talking about, let me know in the comments, please. I appreciate that. I do know, I think I know who this David is, but I'm not going to say it just yet. So I said, "Has David hurt you before?" And then I heard, "Of course." But then I heard, "I'm okay now." And then somebody said, "Enough." Like they were having a conversation. I said, "Was your relationship bad with David?" And then I didn't get anything on that question. Like, it didn't make sense. I don't think she wanted to answer that one. Okay, and then I went back to the location again. I said, "Name the place we can look for you." I heard around Avocado. And then I asked that question again. I heard south. And then I heard west. So those were the three, because I asked it until I can get kind of an idea of how she wants us to travel. So like, here's Avocado. I think we're going to end up having to drop down south and go west. And if you look at the map, that actually takes you by that road I said. And so I think it's in that direction back towards Selma. That's just my opinion, of course. Okay. I said, "Kings River, is that the location for you, Jalissa?" And then you heard the bridge by the woods. So I've heard bridge like six different times in this whole thing. I was like, okay. So I didn't record it because I was at work and I had an earbud and I was writing down the questions and writing down the answers. So that's as close to it as I could. I said, "Was your dad the only, oh, not your dad. I said, was David, I don't know why I said dad, sorry. Was David the only one who hurt you, Jalissa?" And then it said, "Don't be so naive." I don't know. Maybe there was more people in her life that hurt her. Maybe that's what she meant by that. Okay. And then I asked if she met up with her brother. Wasn't she trying to call her brother? So I said, "Hey, was your brother there?" And she said, "No, ask him." Didn't show. So I think she was trying to hang out with her brother and he never got to meet up. I said, "Jalissa," I was like, I said, "Did you know David?" And then it said, "For real." So somebody named David that is in Jalissa's life is what I keep getting. Now I let the spirit box tell me that name. I did not go for it. I just asked the question and the name came out and it kept coming out. So take it as you will, guys, but that's what I have on the Jalissa. I do feel like that location of my map, her energy map that I did for her, is very close. There's a lot of things that Mystic Brady hit on in that map. She hit on the tower, the trees, the cliff, the ravine. So somewhere in that area, I just think that it's not in Sanger or Salem, but everything east up to the Avocado, maybe even a little southern and then a little north in the mountains. That's close as I can, and it's such a big, vast area, and I get that. But she is definitely still with her vehicle, and her vehicle has been pushed. I don't think she volunteered the gas, but maybe somebody pushed the gas pedal to get the vehicle to go and then rolled out of the car and let it off into the ravine. Because I don't think she was driving. I honestly, at first, thought I saw her climbing into the back seat, and that kind of threw me off. But if her car had went down after it had landed and she was still alive, she might have climbed up into the back seat. But, I'm just seeing what I'm seeing, and so take it as you will. I love you guys. Thank you guys for watching. Thank you for subbing. If you have questions or comments, leave them in the comment area. I will get back to you. I'm sorry I am behind on my comments. I apologize. It's just been raining here. Not like physically, but mentally. So as soon as I can and I have a few moments, I will definitely drop some lines for y'all and give everybody hearts at least and comment back as soon as I can. Okay. Love y'all. Have a good night. Maybe.
Bye, guys.